Hello, this module presents an overview of the influences of litigation and legislation and ethical issues regarding assessment. As special educators, not only are we tasked with assessing our students to determine what to teach them, but federal legislation requires certain assessments to hold the education system as a whole accountable for the education of students with disabilities. When students are not assessed accurately, they might receive the wrong education and services. When this happens, families can file a complaint and request for mediation from the State Department of Special Education Services. Not only does this break down relationships, but it also delays children's access to free and appropriate education. Let's get started with an overview of the legal highlights from 1975 to 2004. Public Law 94-142, also known as the Education for All Handicapped Children Act, mandated that education agencies ensure an appropriate assessment and education for individuals with disabilities. State education authorities and local education authorities must monitor compliance with this law. Several reauthorizations of the original legislation have occurred over the past 40 years. Each reauthorization tweaks the law by adding amendments and sometimes changing its name. After each reauthorization, regulations, which are the legal guidelines for implementing the law, are written. Each state then writes their regulations. School districts then adjust their policies, procedures, and paperwork. No Child Left Behind and IDEA 2004 focus points include the accountability of achievement by students with disabilities, reduction of paperwork for educators and other professionals, reduction of the non-instructional time spent by teachers, that is, time spent completing paperwork and attending meetings, providing additional means to resolve disagreements between schools and parents, increasing early intervention activities and aligning this effort with No Child Left Behind, improving teacher quality, and mandating efforts by state education agencies to decrease disproportionality of ethnic and cultural representations in special education. Improvement of discipline policies of earlier legislation. The IDEA law contains mandates to promote fair, objective assessment practices and due process procedures. Due process is the legal recourse when parents or schools disagree with evaluation or placement recommendations. At the initial evaluation, parents, state agencies, or local education agencies may initiate a request for an initial evaluation. Then, multidisciplinary teams must conduct a full and individualized evaluation in all areas of a suspected disability to determine if a child is eligible to receive special education and/or related services. This comprehensive educational evaluation must be completed before a child may receive special education and/or related services. The evaluation must be completed within 60 days of the request. Initial evaluations and subsequent reevaluations cannot take place without parental informed consent. Surrogate parents or guardians may also provide consent. If a child is a ward of the state, local education agencies must try to find the parents, but if unable, they may proceed with the evaluation. Consent for a re-evaluation does not mean consent for the receipt of special education and/or related services. If a parent refuses to give consent or does not respond to requests, there are two options. The first, the local education agency does not provide service in special education. The second would be the local education association may pursue legal means or due process to force the evaluation. When the parent has been fully informed of all educational activities to be conducted. This includes why the student needs the evaluation, what evaluation procedures will be used, and informed consent was provided in the native language or mode of communication of the parent, if the languages are other than English. Accommodations must be made for parents with hearing or visual impairments. Parents must be notified of any action proposed by the local education authority regarding initial evaluation and other options considered, and what rights they have to a mediation hearing if they disagree with what the local education agency suggests. IDEA contains provisions for due process for parents and schools to resolve their differences. Due process procedures are explained in the procedural safeguards. Independent educational evaluations are when a professional outside of the district conducts testing on a student. Parents may get one of these if they disagree with the district's findings. Resolution sessions are established to avoid a formal hearing and must be held within 15 days of the complaint. These may be waived by parents, but then mediation would happen. Mediation is when the district provides a hearing for mediation at no cost to the parents. Mediation is voluntary on the part of the school and the parents, and it cannot be used by a local education agency to delay parental rights to a hearing or to deny any other rights provided in the regulation. Mediation is to be conducted by qualified and impartial trained mediators. In the event that the parents and district cannot come to an agreement, they may file a complaint and request an impartial due process hearing. The parents and the school both explain their side of the disagreement before an impartial hearing officer, a person qualified to hear the case, who then renders a decision. In the event that an impartial due process hearing still does not resolve the issue, a state-level hearing or an appeal in civil court may be filed. Note, while all of this is going on, the student remains in the placement with the services he or she was receiving when the complaint was filed. This is called the stay-put provision. Section 504 is a civil rights law whose purpose is to prevent discrimination against individuals with disabilities in programs receiving federal financial assistance. It extends beyond the categories of IDEA. Similar procedural safeguards and evaluation requirements as IDEA stand for Section 504.